64th Annual Utica Boilermaker Road Race. We expect to see runners coming around that corner any moment, and the spectators bring them on in. We haven't been able to get our spotter to give us a number, so we're as much in the dark about what's going to happen as you are out on the course, so let's just watch the action. Got another wheelchair athlete coming around the corner. Let's bring our wheelchair athlete across the finish line.
Here he comes, ladies and gentlemen, from Syracuse, New York, in the wheelchair division, Larry Arnold. And our elite runners, now we see the media truck in the way and coming down. Here is Larry Arnold coming across the line.
And the media truck is now into view. So spectators, just moments from now, you will see our lead male runners coming around the corner. Here comes our next couple of TV vehicles coming around. So we have the lead entourage, and we know that means only one thing, that those world-class elite runners are right behind. So we are waiting with anticipation to see who our 2011, it is going to be a battle. There are two runners. They are coming into view. They are pumping their arms. They are working. They're approximately 250 meters to go. So let's bring them on in. These are your 1-2 finishers in this year's 2011 Boilermaker Road Race. But who is going to be number one is still very much uncertain. Coming into the final straightaway, two runners. And that is Peter Kamei and Ridaway Harumi. Here comes Harumi with his patented kick. He is looking back. He is raising his hands. Ridaway Harumi in the 40s, unofficial time, 43:29, with a blistering kick in the final straightaway. Your 2009 champion, Ridaway Harumi, has added his second title here at the Boilermaker. And here comes Shadrick Koski, and a very tight battle there between Stephen Mwangi and Samuel Dureba across the finish line. So our top four runners all breaking 44 minutes. Next to the line, we have Simon Durangu at the finish line. And let's welcome Meshek Kirwa from Kenya. And we're looking to see who our first American will be. Once again, high expectations.